continuing with the series, in the fourth preview of the 12-part opponent video series, we're going to talk about the 2011 Bethune-Cookman Wildcats. When you look at the Wildcats on the field, you think, okay, they have a great marching band, the Marching Wildcats. However, in 2010, the football team got more attention than the band did. Why? Well, under second-year coach Brian Jenkins, the Cats went 10-2. And want to share the MEAC title. They also made their first FCF playoff game since 2003, and they also want to share the National Black College Football Championship. Now, with recent success, there's going to come bigger expectations in Daytona Beach in 2011, and it'll be put to the test right away. Now, on defense, they returned some key players. One of those players is senior linebacker Ryan Lewis, who was named a preseason MEAC Defensive Player of the Year and was also named to the All-MEAC First Team. Also returning on the defensive ends, Ryan Davis, linebacker Reggie Sanderlands, and safety Michael Williams. Now, remember, there are no defensive players on a preseason All-MEAC team. Now, offensively, they return offensive lineman Marquel Rozier, who was a All-MEAC second teamer, Nathaniel Curry, and Alex Monroe. They also return preseason All-MEAC second team Isidore Jackson at running back and wide receiver Eddie Poole. Now, when you look at Bethune-Cookman, I looked at their preseason, at the MEAC preseason poll, and they got more first place votes than any team in their conference. That consists of head coaches and SIDs at the respective universities of the MEAC conference. In fact, let me give you an idea. They received 8 first place votes, 2 more than the next highest total in the poll. However, the favorite to win that league is South Carolina State. Now, while number 2 preseason MEAC ranking might be music to the fans of the Wildcats in Daytona Beach, but for Brian Jenkins, it means nothing, because he has to focus on the schedule. And the only FBS team on their schedule is a trip to Miami on October 1st. And they don't leave the state of Florida until October 8th, when they go up to North Carolina A&T. Now, they're a very good team. I mean, let's make no mistake about it. You know they're going to be up when they play Miami on October 1st. But when you look at that schedule, there's no reason why they can't win 10 again this year. In fact, I'm predicting for Bethune-Cookman in 2011 of 10-2 and a trip back to the FCS playoffs. Now, this was a short preview, but come tomorrow in part 5 of the 12-part video series, I'm going to talk about a team that has won the ACC 4 of the last 6 years and is favored to do so again this year, and that's the Virginia Tech Hokies. See you then. Bye for now.